Why yesterday?
That's a good question, and I think for the Browns, you know, the two of the last three games, you had the Steelers game and the Chargers game that really were kind of ugly performances. And for this team, it's such a young team, and while we all know it's been brutal the last couple of years, they've showed some signs of life. And I think when John Dorsey and Jimmy and Dee Haslam sat down and looked at everything, I think they realized that a change had to be made. And they obviously, with it both being head coach Hugh Jackson and offensive coordinator Todd Haley, I think they felt that the environment that was being created was not the right one for Baker Mayfield, who is the franchise, or the rest of this young team. And so you heard talks yesterday about internal discord, and I think they just wanted to make sure this is an organization that is functioning. I mean, I've been there 6 years. I have seen regimes come and go. I've seen infighting in the past, and I think with John Dorsey there, along with the Haslams, now they said, no more of this. We're not having it anymore. It's time for a change. And I will say, I think Hugh Jackson, in many ways, was dealt a very unfair hand, at least in his first 2 years, you know, where he finished 1-31. And I think that that albatross, whether it was just or not, was too big, and too big for the fan base and too big for the team. And so when you had that on top of what was going on in the building with Hugh and Todd Haley, I think they just said, you know what, it's enough. The priority number one is developing Baker Mayfield and this young team, and we need to put them in the best environment possible going forward.
But you have these two coaches take a selfish approach here, Hugh Jackson and Todd Haley. Nate, if I knew that Todd Haley was going to be combustible and not going to work out, they had to know inside, even though he's a great offensive mind and you're bringing him in to help Baker Mayfield, you also have to have two guys who get along. When did this relationship get fractured, or was it ever a relationship?
You know, I think that's a million-dollar question, Dan, and I would say that in this business, as you well know, being around so many people in the NFL and even in your business in broadcasting, there are so many egos involved. And Hugh Jackson made it to the point that he was the head coach of the Cleveland Browns by being the NFL's assistant coach of the year as an offensive coordinator for the Cincinnati Bengals back in 2015. Todd Haley has presided over the number two offense in the NFL for the last 6 years with the Pittsburgh Steelers. So I would imagine both of those guys would think, hey, I know how to do this as well as anybody on the planet. And I think that setup, you know, was difficult. For Hugh, last year he had so much on his plate. He was the head coach, he was the offensive coordinator, and he was trying to handhold DeShone Kizer, who was not ready to play through an entire season. And I think this year they thought it would be a good idea to take some things off the plate. But you could see, I think, from the beginning and even on Hard Knocks that, you know, this might be a tough relationship to have go smoothly unless there's, you know, without question, success. And I think when things started to go badly, and I think the last 3 weeks we certainly saw the offense regress. In fact, last week, you know, you go into the middle of the fourth quarter with -1 yards of offense in the second half. And the comments Hugh made following the Tampa Bay game where he said he was going to get involved, which were born out of frustration. I think at that point you knew something had to give. And yesterday, being in the building in Berea, I ran into Hugh, who I would consider a friend of mine. And, you know, I was felt awful for him. But we were on the air doing Cleveland Browns Daily at about 1:07 when the first report came out about Todd Haley. So yesterday I was kind of shocked. I thought it might be an either or, and they're going to bring one person out and try to go forward. But John Dorsey and the Haslam said, nope, we've had enough, and both guys were out yesterday.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.